The first intermolecular force is the force that exists between an ion and a polar compound. So this is called ion dipole. Now an example of ion dipole is we could have NaCl. Remember, this is sodium chloride, it's ionic, and we throw it into water. Now, ionic compounds are polar compounds, and they're highly polar because, remember, we've talked about this before. We say if your difference in electronegativity is 0.4 or greater, you're going to be polar. If it's greater than 1.7 and higher, you're going to be ionic. So the difference in their electronegative numbers is very high. So it's going to be a polar type of compound. All ionic compounds are polar. And we're going to learn that water, which is called a universal solvent, it's called universal because it's highly polar. So it dissolves a lot of polar things. Okay. So polar ionic compound, polar solvent, which is water, polar and polar will interact. So the polar water is going to split this up into its ions. Na is in group 1a, so it's going to be Na positive, aqueous, plus Cl minus aqueous. Remember, Cl is in group 7a, so it's minus 1. Now, what does aqueous mean? All aqueous means is that the water is actually wrapping itself around the ions. This is the ion-dipole interaction. And if we wanted to see what it looks like, let's say we took the sodium ion. Now, aqueous again means that the water is surrounding it. But which parts of the water are surrounding it? We should realize that oxygen is very electronegative. This compound here is polar if we follow the rules. Because it's polar, we're going to say that one end is partially positive, the other end is partially negative. Oxygen has a larger electronegative number, so this end will be partially negative. The hydrogens are less electronegative, so they're going to be partially positive. Sodium is positively charged, and remember, which side of the water is going to be attracted with it? Opposites attract. So the negative portion of the water will be attracted to it, the partially negative portions. And it's not only going to be one molecule surrounding the ion, it's going to be multiple water molecules surrounding it because we're in solution. It's in a bucket of water. There's hundreds and hundreds of water molecules all around. So they all try to surround the ion. So it's the interaction between the ion, the positive ion, and the partially negative end of the water molecule. This little dashed green line means that it's not a full bond. It's just an interaction. They're communicating with each other. They're partially attracted to each other. Intermolecular forces are not bonding forces. Remember, we're going to say that intramolecular forces are bonding forces. Intermolecular forces are not bonding forces. They're not bonding. They're just attracted to one another. So these little green lines are just an attraction for the positive ion to the partially negative oxygen. And if we drew chlorine, we'd show that the partially positive ends, the hydrogens, would be attracted to the negative chlorine. That would be our ion dipole interaction. So here's an example of ion dipole, and we're going to say basically fundamentally is we have ion dipole anytime we have an ionic compound dissolving in a polar liquid like water. Water is polar based on the rules that we learned.